Welcome back, another week, another problem. Today's the farming. This girl, 17 days calved. Noticed a few days ago a bad smell of her rear end. I'm passing a bit of pink stuff, pressing her, so my initial instinct was that it was a retained placenta, or the cleanings are still inside her, or some of them still inside her anyway. So off to the vets is the plan now, and get antibiotic and maybe a painkiller and Metricure to flush her out. She's not sick, but she's not thriving, and she's a little dull in the eye, but she's eating, so hopefully the problem's got in time and it'll be able to be sorted out, because that could run into a displaced stomach, which would be a big thing, and it could be the end of her. So I'm going to give her the stuff and get her up to a straw bed of pen and see what she does, depending on what she eats. Maybe throw a bit of hay for roughage to get the stomach going. So I'll keep you informed of how it goes anyway. Yeah, I got stuff in the vet for her, Betamox and a couple of Metricure, and put them into her. She's in good form, she's bending. Yes, hay and failures there. And I think she'll be okay. I'll watch her for a day or two, but I don't think she's too bad. Now, get me quad serviced this evening. Good wash down and into Jason. You could hear the skateboard's more engine repair. She's going to service it for me. Before I get too busy with wanting it with cows and grass and that, so get done now when the time is quiet to get it done. as my quad goes off for a service, my 25 comes back from a service. Just over at QC's garage and poles to get a few jobs done on it. Ended up with a new clutch, got the brakes going, got a new stand here on it, new seat cushions. Oil leaks, was a diesel leak and an oil leak, both were repaired. New ply lamp in the back of it. So yeah, just got back to it this evening. So it'll come back and the quad will go. That'll leave everything service for the upcoming year. That cow you hear roaring there is a homesick cow. Neighbour across the road, been in a new parlour and a cow calved before the job was complete and just making up for him a few days. But she's homesick, that's what she's roaring about. Now it's a day later and my cow thankfully is a lot better. Injected her this morning again after the milking. A lot more life to her. She's eating nuts, she's eating silage, she's eating hay. She's actually out the pallet now, she's eating grass as well. So I think that back plus one. I'll inject her again tomorrow and suss her out, but I think she's on the road to recovery. Two girls in here getting close to being in the family way. This one, the bones is slightly sunk. She'll probably do it tonight, maybe this evening. This one's further on, probably next few hours, she'll be doing it. So look, we'll try and get a bit of footage if we can of what the bones on. Not guaranteed, but we'll try. So we'll talk to you shortly again. Now here we are. It's 5:03 in the morning. So obviously I didn't do much filling of the footage. Filling of this cow camera. Watching from the bed on the phone camera, but anyway. She has herself there and it's 5:03 and it's a freezing bull. Yeah. And what can I say? Only I'm gonna get this calf fed and get back to my bed. Other one's not far away from it, she'll do it probably before morning too. Well, before daylight, we'll say. It is morning, but she'll do it in a few hours too, I think. I shouldn't use them words back to bed. Because here I am, 20 to 4, 45 minutes later. Number 2. So, don't think I'm going to bed until this is starting. I'm taking a beating and just... meet the ball and go to bed or something. Another boy here. So, I'm going to repeat myself by saying I'm going to feed the calf and go back to bed. Chat to you tomorrow. Next day, there's two calves there, 903 and 904. Was born last night. Two bull calves, two good bull calves. They're healthy and they're happy and they're quiet, so that was a good one. I'm heading off now to buy some urea, so chat to you soon.
is or not a sandcastle.
That's some out.
Yeah, so this is it. First fertilizer of 2023 and the maiden voyage with the new spreader. Even though the stuff I've seen there was damp in the bag. But that's the hammer and I broke it up, you know, so hopefully the most of it is true anyway. Maybe break some outlets at the end, but so hopefully ground will carry me. It should ground quite well for the time of year. So we'll try and see if we get on. Urea. Half bag to make, we're going to go and integrate it in. Well, every great dredging we can do, depending on how dry it is, but most of it should be trafficable at this stage. That's the word, trafficable. Trafficable, I suppose, is the word, and what we've done, you know what I mean? I'm going to open this gap with trash present. first spreader full gone with me new Cavallo 890. Very happy with it. It's very good spreader, same as my last one, which is a good one too. No problems or complaints with it at all. Ground is just in great condition for the time of year for County Cavan. It's hard to believe that it's dry. It's 1st of March. Four paddocks done there. The four paddocks wouldn't be the driest fellas in the farm. I never recall them done this early before. The rocky ones and dry ones were done in February most years, but it was mid-March before. And all these ones are done now, that I'm doing now. That's maybe 2.5 weeks later than now. So it's very good to have them done so early with urea, and it's been the grass on now for the cows as well. They've been in it all with plenty of grass, hopefully, into April. So, it's all good. The four paddocks done, there's only mark bit. So I'm going to put the truck now and go into the picking and river, calf feeding and get back at it tomorrow. But the dry paddocks issue, whatever, but the wet ones won't be first, obviously, in case with the rust break. So far, so good. All is good. It's better enough to fertilize it and see how it goes tomorrow. We'll talk later.
Anyway, so it's now Thursday night again. We'll upload this video tonight. I said I'd do Thursday nights, but I'll try and do as much as I can. And last week's wasn't until Saturday, but sure. So that's days of calving cows and days of farming. We'll try and get them for Thursday if we can from now on. So that's a great week weather-wise. Very little rain, great drying. Land's fierce dry for the time of year. Fertilizer went out, that them no problem at all. Do more now tomorrow, do the wet paddocks tomorrow. I maybe need them till the weather goes to break. As long as I can. Mother coming for calving tonight, so we'll see what she has in the next video. Sure, look, that's me for now. We'll call it a week. We'll chat soon again. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and like and share, and thank you for your support, and we'll talk soon again. Bye-bye.